give us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the Lord. Just one word from the Lord.
That is written in it. Because this is the true success to this life. This is the true prosperity preaching. Is that we as Christians have to get into the word. And then it says, then you will be prosperous and successful. Again, most of us, as I said Sunday, if I was to ask the people to raise their hand, all of us want to be prosperous and successful. Raise your hand, and everybody probably would raise their hands. Everybody with any good sense anyway. Because we all want this. We all want this. And we all have to be willing to do what we need to do to get this kind of success. This kind of success comes only by studying the Word. And the more successful that you become in this life, you need to study it even more. Study it even more. So that your reign, where you are, at your job, the people that you're over, that they may prosper because you know the Word. Men, that your families may prosper because you're living out the Word. This Saturday will be our brother's keepers. One of the foundational truths is that we want to keep Christ first. And the only way we can keep Christ first is we've got to get into the book. We've got to get into the book. We've got to get into the book. So how to be successful in success? Six foundational truths. The first truth is don't put man in God's place. The second truth is don't put marriage in God's place, or the pursuit of love in God's place. Don't put money in God's place. You say, okay, preacher, what do I do? The first thing I do is I reverence in heaven and God. The second thing that I do is that I remember humility. No matter how blessed I become, I remember that I'm just like my brother. Yeah. Nobody, for I'm not better than anybody else. If we can keep that, you can reign in harmony. You can reign in harmony. And interestingly enough, that's the success key to anything, to our family life. Don't put your husband or before God. Don't put marriage before God. Don't put money before God. Many times marriages end. The major reason is because of money. Money issues. Don't do that. Put your reverence in God and study the Word and see what your role is in the marriage, what it is God is calling you to do in the marriage, and do it. Be careful to do it. And remember, in humility in your family, men, though God has placed you over as head of your households, you have to remember, even though I'm the head, I'm no better than my wife. I'm no better than my children. God didn't place me as head of my family so that my family can serve me, but He put me head of my family so that I can serve my family. I can serve my wife. I can serve my children because I'm not any better than they are. I can do anything in the household that my wife is doing. There's some men in marriage that won't do certain things. There's some men that had children and they never changed their children's diaper. A shame, a shame, a shame. You're no better than she is, and vice versa. But you got to be humble to realize that. Remember humility. Remember humility. And it works in marriage. It works in church. It works in the corporate world. You get a promotion and God places people under you. You remember, hey, I'm no better than them. I know I'm over umpteen many people, but I'm no better than them. I just have a different occupation, a different task to do. And you remain humble, and instead of ruling over them, serve them. And when you serve them, your reign will be in harmony. These are the true keys to success. To success. It works in churches as well. And trying to grow and build a church, the pastor has to remember that I'm no better than anybody else that comes through the door. And vice versa with any leaders in the church. We're no better than anybody else. We're no better. Remember humility. And we can reign in harmony. Amen. 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 And praise the Lord. How to be a success in success, part two. Shall
the calm on the sea? But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction. From above, we